explain how the Yesable group, Buffalo, by the way, I know they're the 4 seed, but they didn't think their stadium was adequate enough, so they go to Dakota. So Buffalo technically is the better team. They're number 4, Dakota's is number 13. Dakota's getting the benefit of the run by Empire State last year to get such a better seed. So Dakota's will be trying to do what the Reverend Empire did and win the first round match. Buffalo, not going to win this one.
Shut out.
I think they might.
a big letdown by the defense. This is when the leaders on the field need to step up and calm down the players so they can regroup and try to stop this offense in the next set of downs.
There you have it, folks. They really earned it out there today.
Down by 22. They're going to try to win this game. And it ain't over till it's over. It might be worse. You got to play in very cold
weather. Sometimes as a quarterback, you have so many things to worry about. The coverage, where the pressure coming from, and so on, that you lose focus in time throwing a catchable ball.
Up
here, he just missed the contest.
Like, they line up at the 49. And 7 and 9 to go.
Sure, why not?
From the shotgun.
They're like, sure, why not?
Ball complete. I know that pass was fired pretty hard, but you still have to.
I'm like, sure, why not?
The only reason it's out there is to catch the football.
The
ball
line up with a single setback here.
To the line!
He got the first down! To the 13!
26 yards!
They're building some great momentum on this drive, Brad. That's right, Brad. That was a crisp pass by the quarterback. They're looking pretty good moving the ball right now. Alright, so first down, 10 yards to go. They're in the red zone.
Dakota had any major injuries. I hope not. Michael Foy, 13 for 25. James Robinson, but I think Barrow is the guy. There's no injuries. Excellent. We'll give you the box score, 22-6. Blue for the better. Pair of field goals, and then Boyd to Freeman to make it 12-0. They didn't get the extra point. Dakota and Alexander sealed it. They'll have to wait till tomorrow to find out their opponent, because Toledo and Oregon are due. What is it? That's not Saturday. Whatever.
Hi, everybody. This is Brad Nessler. With me, as always, Lee Corso with Kurt Curve Street.
Degrees in Las Vegas. They're having something wrong.
And we're set to bring
Dakota
you
State would love nothing more but to give it to Penn State.
The Nittany Lions are confident bunch of kids, and rightfully so. Kurt, this team is just too powerful.
Penn State is led by their running
back. Royster.
I'm curious to talk to him about this game, and believe me, he is ready to run all over this defense. Coach,
to
have a big game on the ground.
You're
absolutely right.
No-brainer. It's a no-brainer. That's what I say. If they're not affected by any injuries,
State is lined up to kick the ball off first, and we are ready to go.
Tomorrow.
And it's a short kickoff.
And no team affected by injuries.
McGrew.
McGrew.
Now we'll get to see how his quarterback can do today.
Penn State would love to have him work, but give Dakota's a lesson. Dakota's beat Buffalo. I mean, Buffalo, they could have fucked it up.
They'll go to work at the 25.
Well, they know that Northern Illinois and Ohio State are on the other side of the country, especially Ohio State. Boy, he's got to throw. Dan, right to Sean.
What an interception by the quarterback.
I love it.
Oh, that was quick. That was like one play. Seven seconds later, as they step off, should be a pumpy.
We'll see if they can capitalize on the good field position.
Yeah, they have to worry about Ohio State on the other side of the bracket.
Line up with three wide.
And Penn State can pull something off. Schumer! Not bad.
23. Everybody was cool on that one. And that was a good job here by the quarterback. That could have play fake in the real way.
Yeah, so yeah, they're like, we can get through. Ohio State is probably waiting on the other side. Ohio State has to deal with Northern Illinois. And Northern Illinois are no slouches. They beat Oklahoma.
They
got this one. Collins has to throw. Back to Schuler. 6 yards. Yeah. Here's the thing. No group has a 1-4 or 2-3 seeding matchup for the round of 16 no matter what. Tomorrow, the way for both. And Harding's got the ball.
Wow, the receiver had a big play in his mind. He forgot about securing the football.
So here's the thing. Connor Bowles, the Notre Dame, someone seed, Iowa, some 4th seed. Iowa went out in the first round. Number 2 is Michigan, number 3 San Diego State. But San Diego State lost in overtime. So. To the left for Robinson. Not bad. Side of 10. 6 yards.
Nice little batter there.
Number 1 Cincy went out in the Fiesta Bowl, so no 1-4 there. 2-3 matchup. Ohio State would face Oklahoma, but Oklahoma got taken down by Boston College. I mean, not Boston College, but Oklahoma got taken out by NI.
Right.
Oh man, that's a pick! And if he can be speedster, wow! That is a mistake! Good lord! How can you touchdown? Of course, order. Barrow's got the first down. If he can hold on to the ball, and he will. Antonio Barrow. First down and 10 at the 12. Suppose would like to march downfield and at worst go for a field goal to tie the game.
These young men should hold their heads up high today.
Barrow! Touchdown! Dakota State! Oh my gosh! We found the hole on the right side. Antonio Barrow! Watch this. Perfect hole! He's in the end zone. Penn State does have a minute 11, though, to come back, win this game, and take control of things. The kid, tip off. By Booth. 13 versus 12, by the way, because both of them were actually going to lose.
Everyone's all lined up.
Whoever wins this game, the only way that would be, if Oregon wins, they're the home team in Atlanta.
Moore.
No.
Guys, what do you think about
Dakota's
this?
Is trying to do what their custom brethren Empire State did. Go to the second round against a superstar team and shock everyone by winning. Empire went on to crush Marshall in the 16 and then get close to A&M. Collins. Picked off by Fry! Picked off! By Fry! Oh my goodness! Watch this. Oh, he overthrew his receiver. Badly overthrew his receiver. And now Dakota's got to go downfield.
They'll take over. At the 31.
I don't think they can kick a 40-yard field goal. That has to be shorter than that. Barrow wrestling himself for 4.
He picks up 4 yards on the carry.
As well. Last week. So it's second and six.
It's second down, 6 yards to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. Boyd with three wide receivers.
Barrel. No, they saw him. Mine was white. They'll probably have to patch because I don't think he left for that 3 yards.
No question. He got tremendous penetration and was able to wrap him up for a loss there.
There's that at 28. It'll be a 45-yard kick, and I don't know if he has the leg for that.
Boyd comes to the line. Three wide. Boyd drops the throw.
Over the middle for Johnson. He's got it. Oh, no, he fumbled. He fumbled the ball. Oh, my gosh. That might have been six. Oh, my God. How does he replay? How fast he went? He's over the middle. He's at the five. Jack Ham. They said Ham recovered it. But Ham's 51, isn't he? I think it was 28. He was at the, he was inside the 5 yard line. He was inside the 5 yard line. From there is either a clear path for a touchdown run or a field goal. He's gonna throw. He throws, he's got McDuffie and he's got a flag. Oh, it's holding. It is holding. You know what they're gonna do. I say he's got to call timeout. Yeah, they have to call timeout because the clock did not, the clock stops for a defensive penalty, but it doesn't stop for an offensive penalty. Oh my God. And he's in trouble. Oh, it's a safety. Collins. Marker, a safety. Now they have to punt. Armstrong, oh, thank God for that.
Wow, barely close to turning it over, but they'll keep possession of the football. Way to play heads up out there. That's just one more reason to play to the whistle.
The offense 47.
The 47
yard line. He can kneel down.
Takes the spike. We're going to throw it. He's wrapped up for the sack. The offense calls the timeout, and they've got two remaining.
16-10. I punted right now. Honestly, I punted. They're going to punt. Yeah, they're going to punt. They're going to punt the ball.
And this is strange. The punter's on the field right now, and I'm not quite sure what's going on.
Well, that's a smart move because that's going to force Penn State. And the clock might run down.
He gets it off.
Taylor, fumble! Schuler got it. 2 seconds left. I think that's a smart thing for Dakotas to do. Because they need a 78-yard touchdown
to win the game.
They'll get the ball here.
Well, remember, Ohio State, Virginia Tech, Bama.
He eats it.
Got Schuler! But they're going to tackle him at the midfield line. They tackled him! It's happened! Unbelievable! It's happened! Just like Empire State last year, Dakota State does what the Reverend did and shocked the world! Unbelievable! 16-10, Dakota's win! They're going to Atlanta! Wow! Oh my God! And Penn State again! Again, Penn State loses to an inferior team. They lost to Toledo in 2016. They lost to Central Florida in 2017. And now they lose to Dakota State in 2018. What is with this team? They're jinxed. Look at the numbers. It favors Penn State, but yet they've lost 16-10. They had better third down conversions, 2 for 9. Dakota didn't hit a third down, yet they still won the game. They turned the ball over 3 times. That fumble should have given Penn State a chance. And they had the, they had a first down and then stupidly a hold call. Individual stats. Wow. Royster was hurt, but They had a couple of they had Royster and they had Schuler. Well, Schuler, I can't understand it. I don't understand it. Dakota State. 14 for them, no injuries. Crushed Georgia Southern 32-14 before crushing Toledo 24-6. So they've steamrolled past their two opponents. Hopefully they steamroll over Dakota's and have a big date with Ohio State in Arizona. That would be a good game for the quarterfinals. Dakota's tried to duplicate what Empire State did last year and get to the quarterfinals.
Hey, who do you think I'm thinking? Go
Ducks! So Oregon will kick off first.
The kicker's got the ball set up and we're ready to get this thing started.
Ready to go.
Now let's see what kind of success this offense can have as they come on out of the field for the first time today.
This would be a good quarterfinals. Ohio State said, we don't care who we play in Arizona, we're going to win. Yeah, the weird thing is, you know, we're going to get this time off. And then we're going to end up playing three games in 4 days. We're going to play the quarterfinals on Wednesday, the semi on Friday, and then Saturday. Saturday night you do the final.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Three wideouts here. Boy, back to throw.
We're too right for Johnson. Yep. They're calling five, right? Oh yeah, they're calling five.
Yep.
That was a terrible net.
10 seconds for the
defender. It's only a 5 yard call. So now if they don't get the first down, then obviously the 5 yard is probably not making.
Very impressive.
Dakota's giving them all the credit in the world. to beat Penn State.
Oregon.
Nobody gave him a chance.
Because
Penn State, Bryant, will get
7 yards.
They want to keep the ball. They want to make sure that Dakota's does not get a chance to score any points. Remember, Dakota's had to shut it against Buffalo, and then Buffalo ended up coming out of fucking nowhere, scores some points. They'll get the 3 points to Dakota's. I mean to Oregon. So Oregon will win 20-0 on Dakota's. A big shutout. I mean, yeah, it's a shutout. But Dakota's for getting this far, getting to the Sweet 16. Many teams, they get Auburn didn't get this far. Michigan didn't even get that far with Dakota State. They didn't really have anything good. Kick return yards, but that was mostly because of teams. So Siler, Mariano, DeMoss, and then Campbell. That's all they had to do. Oh, Kenny Anderson was the starting quarterback. Thankfully for Anderson, he will be okay, so Mariano won't have to play Ohio State. Got about 2 weeks. Who's gone for 2 weeks? John Maxwell. So Oregon loses Maxwell.